Hey guys, it's Miles. I am at my home in Pennsylvania. It's week two of quarantine, but I finally got around to finishing this video. And I think it's right around the time that RD decisions just came out, so that was good timing. Congratulations if you were admitted, class of 2024. Hope to see you guys on campus. And this video was basically just a super last minute idea that a couple friends and I had. I think we decided the night before to get up the next day, shoot a video, essentially giving you guys a Vanderbilt tour. We are tour guides, but this video is in no way affiliated with like the tour guide official group, so this is just something that we decided to do. And we tried to kind of stay away from the academics and the stuff that you can find on the Vanderbilt website and give you more of an insight into student life here. We don't get too in-depth, so feel free to add any questions you have in the comments. I can do another video, or you can feel free to even like email me. I'll leave my email in the description. But yeah, that's about it. Hope you enjoy the video and feel free to reach out. Due to the coronavirus, all tours and admitted students events have been canceled for the rest of the school year. So we decided we'd give you guys a little bit of a glimpse into our life at Vanderbilt.
I know for us, our tour was a major factor in our decision to come here. So we just wanted to give you guys a little glimpse of what it's like on campus.
It could actually be our last day here. A lot of us are leaving tomorrow and university has not told us whether we will be returning in April. So here it is. We'll start by introducing ourselves. My name is Miles Brasky. I'm a first year in the College of Arts and Science with a major in public policy and a minor in Spanish from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
Hi, I'm Michael Berry. I am a first year in the College of Arts and Science, double majoring in public policy and Asian studies. I'm from Rochester Hills, Michigan.
Hi, I'm Swathi. I'm from Boston, Massachusetts. I'm a first year in the College of Arts and Science, looking to major in economics and medicine, health, and society.
Right.
Here we go.
Yeah. Do you want to wait?
So here we are on Commons Lawn. This is basically the first year campus where all 10 of the houses are located. Each of these different buildings is a Commons house, which you will be randomly divided on upon your acceptance to Vanderbilt. You will live in either a double or a triple with a randomly assigned roommate, but you're still gonna fill out this pretty extensive roommate survey, so you're not living with someone that lives completely differently than you do. They're mostly single gender floors, a couple co-ed floors, and on each floor there's gonna be an RA that's basically just there for you whenever you need them. What I also think is cool about freshman housing is a faculty head of house lives in each house, which is a faculty member that lives kind of in their own apartment on the first floor of your house, and they host weekly house events like dinners or ice cream socials, and that's for the students to get to know the faculty member and to kind of bring the house together as a whole. Mine is Dr. Helmuth. She's been really great. She's my Spanish professor and also just wrote a letter of recommendation for a scholarship program I applied for, so that's a really great resource to have as well.
And then another really cool thing about just being on Commons is that everyone that you're with is sharing the same experience that you are. You see people when you're walking to dinner, you see friendly faces everywhere you go. And another really cool event that Vanderbilt does on Commons is the Commons Cup. So this is a Hogwarts-style tournament that's between all 10 houses to get the overall prize of the Commons Cup. And it has different events in athletics and environmental sustainability and academics, and it's a really awesome way to build community within your house and also a great way to get competitive.
I think that Vanderbilt does an amazing job with, you know, putting you together with these new people and helping you find people that you really connect with. My floor got really close just in the first couple weeks. I remember walking out like my third or fourth day and a group of people were just like walking by and they're like, oh, want to go to like dinner with us? And so it's really nice to just have these people around you. There's all these events that you can have together. I live in Sutherland all the way back there, but like you walk out the door and you walk for like 2 minutes and you're in Hillsborough Village, which is a nice little village with a lot of cafes and cute shops and a lot of things to do. So, you know, you have your community and you have people to do these things with. Sometimes on Friday nights, we'll take our blankets and pillows and we'll all like drag them down into the seminar room and like flip over the tables and make like little couches out of them and watch a movie together, like with our floor. So there's just so many ways to bond with the people that you're with, and it really becomes a family. I would say that the Commons experience really like helps you find your people.
So we are walking into Hank Ingram Building, which is one of the largest first year dorms, and we're gonna look at a quick sample dorm room.
After 8 o'clock for the dorms, you use your card to get in, and you also show it to the security guard.
Hi.
So, everyone follow me and we'll go into the model room. So this is a pretty standard freshman double. The only thing that might be different is the ceilings might not be as high. But as you can see, pretty roomy.
Everything you see that's wooden comes with the dorm room, and then everything else, like the decorations and the refrigerator, do not come with the dorm room. However, we have like a refrigerator service where you can rent a refrigerator for the whole year, and they will come drop it off in your dorm and come pick it up at the end of the year, so it's super easy.
The walls are made out of what we call these popcorn walls. So it's actually a senior design project, but basically they're self-healing. So you can put tacks in, you can, you know, hang up pictures, hang up all kinds of different stuff, and you just pull them right out. And it's good.
Guys, is anyone gonna watch this when Elliot Choi can just show them?
Well,
you guys are real
tour
guests.
This content before.
That's true.
So this is one of our first year dining halls, but it is open to everyone. It looks a little different usually than it does because they're putting everything in to-go boxes to avoid contamination because of the lovely coronavirus. But they usually have a lot of really awesome options. They have a pasta station, burgers, chicken fingers, Asian. Every morning I have a smoothie from the smoothie bar before my 9 a.m.
I get oatmeal and a bagel and eggs and potatoes.
There's an olive bar and it's free. Along with the main dining halls that we have on campus, there's a lot of fun little niche like places to eat. So we have Susie's Food for Thought, which is a coffee place, and we have the pub, which you can get like burgers and, you know, your classic burgers and fries, milkshakes. There's Greens, which is a vegetarian restaurant, and it has really good food. Their mac and cheese pleases everyone, like not just vegetarians. And we also have like 2301, which is in our main dining hall on main campus, which is free of the 8 main allergens. So there's a lot of options for, you know, any kind of dietary restrictions, or if you want to just try something new, you have a lot of options.
Yeah, the food here is definitely better than my parents' home cooking. I would never tell them that. Hopefully you don't see this, Mom.
Another really cool aspect of dining at Vanderbilt is the Taste of Nashville program. So included in your tuition is $225 each semester to spend at different off-campus restaurants, and there's a list of them that Vanderbilt provides every year, and there's a ton of different options from Mexican food to Indian food to just classic American food, that Nashville favorites and things like that, and you can pay right with your Commodore card. So it's a really cool way if your parents or grandparents come to town, they're like, oh, I'm gonna take you out to dinner to get you away from that university food, and you're like, oh, no, I got it. Meals on Vanderbilt tonight. So it's a really amazing way to go out to eat with your friends. We went out this morning and got brunch on the card, and it's a really awesome program that Vanderbilt provides in addition to our amazing dining halls.
This is Peabody Lawn. If you can hear over
it's
the construction. We're hoping that with all the students gone due to the lovely coronavirus, that the construction can kind of progress a little faster and maybe it'll be done soon.
Yay!
All right, so right now we are on our way to main campus, which is where most of the arts and science classes are located. Right now we are on Peabody. This lawn
when it's usually pretty, is one of the most photographed locations in all of college campuses, but here we are. It'll be better soon.
Come here.
Here,
we're doing a special education stop on a tour. Come here.
Hi, I'm Nora Smith, and I'm a freshman majoring in special education in our Peabody College of Education and Development. And what's really cool about the special education program is that Peabody is nationally ranked as the number one school for special education, and that's pretty cool.
And I'm Kate White, and I'm minoring in special education, which is super awesome because it's really flexible, so you can get involved any way you want to. We also have a bunch of super cool clubs like Special Olympics if you want to get more involved with the special needs community on campus.
Woo!
Yay!
So, hi guys. Last night was kind of crazy because we got news at like 7 p.m. that classes were canceled for the rest of this week and that we were doing online classes for 2 weeks after that. I'm breaking the rules of walking backwards. For Vanderbilt tour guides, we're not allowed to walk backwards.
We're not Vanderbilt tour guides.
Oh, shit. We're not allowed to walk backwards. So it was kind of a crazy experience last night with everyone trying to find flights, leaving campus. But we're really just glad that we have these last couple days to hang out with everyone, maybe for the rest of the year. And it's making us really sad. We've cried a few times.
Michael, what time did you go to bed last night?
I went to bed at 4 a.m. last night.
I went to bed at 6!
And I did not sleep in my own bed.
This is Leah, guys. Leah, say hi. Yeah.
Hi.
Why? Why do you love Vanderbilt?
Because it's the happiest place in the world.
Aww.
And these are really good.
Wait, what is that?
It's from the MRB3 Cafe, and okay, you have to get a frozen latte with vanilla, and it tastes like ice cream.
Okay, I'm gonna go get
it's
that.
So good. Do it. Yeah, do it right now.
Oh my god.
We're doing it.
Yes.
All right, bye.
That friend we just met back there, that's actually one of the friends I made through Vanderbilt University Running Club, which is basically a lot more chill than like our Division I sports. So if you're not a D1 athlete, you can do club sports, which most of them you don't have to try out for, although there's a couple like soccer and lacrosse that you do, and those club sports are an awesome way to have a kind of group of people that you see a couple times a week for practice. You can also travel. I used to do club swim, and I got an all-expense-paid trip to Atlanta, which was absolutely amazing. And on a level even below that is intramural sports. And I cannot say enough good things about intramural sports. I am an avid intramural volleyball player. I had a team of six that were pretty close to winning the sand volleyball championships, I will say. And those are also a great way to kind of meet people, bond with them, and have a great time there.
We are a Division I SEC school, so we have a championship baseball team, a championship winning women's bowling team, a really successful basketball team, and a football team.
You can get into any of these games just with your Commodore card. Games are free, so it's really cool to, you know, just go down to a football game or a basketball game. You know, you're on campus, so you're able to go to these games, and it's a really fun way to, like, you know, just hang out with your friends and watch some sports.
And tailgates. Vanderbilt University loves tailgates.
But you gotta dress up.
You have to dress up.
Cowboy boots.
Cowboy boots for the tailgates. Common theme at Vanderbilt University. Make it to the tailgate, don't make it to the game.
I made it to all the games.
At Vanderbilt, students care about a lot more than just their academics. Clubs and orgs are a huge part of campus life here. There are 400 student-run organizations.
500, 600, 700, 800.
You can make more.
Hundreds of student organizations, and it's really easy to make your own. There is organizations all the way from just normal intramural sports to things like the AVA Doors, which is an organization on campus that learns how to fly planes. Vanderbilt University Theater is a great way to get involved in the arts on campus, and I really enjoy it because my major has nothing to do with creativity and arts, but it really allows me to express myself. Fuck off.
You're so mean.
And then also another thing is I am involved in the business fraternity here on campus, as well as tour guides and, VSAT.
about Greek life. About 40% of students on campus are involved in Greek life, but this number includes social fraternities, professional fraternities, and social fraternities. One thing that's really nice about Greek life on campus, especially for the social fraternities, is that you don't rush until your second semester. So you have your first semester to kind of get adjusted, you know, kind of understand what life on campus is going to be like and see if you're really interested in joining a fraternity or a sorority. Another really cool thing is that only the top six officers live in the each chapter house that you see behind me. So that means that, you know, Greek life is not your entire life. It's really what you make of it. You can be as involved or not involved as you want. In particular for me, I have friends that are both in Greek life and not in Greek life. I personally am in Greek life, but I'm rooming with someone who is in a different chapter, and I'm friends with a lot of people who aren't in Greek life. But it's a really great way to get involved if that's something you're interested in.
So another awesome thing about Vanderbilt is that we are right next to Nashville, which is Music City, an incredible booming city. I think over 100 people move to Nashville every day. And what's really awesome about being so close to Nashville is that it's probably a 20-minute walk or a 10-minute run or a 3-minute Uber to go downtown. There's so many things to do, whether it's concerts or going out to eat or going to music festivals or, is that the same thing as concerts? Anyways, there are so many things to do downtown. Vanderbilt also does a really good job of providing ways for students to be involved in that. So like my second week on campus, I won a raffle to go see Dear Evan Hansen, and I got to bring one of my friends, and they gave us free dinner, and they bussed us down to see Dear Evan Hansen at the Tennessee Performing Arts Center, and the whole night was completely free. I know friends who have gone to Predators games, have seen Ariana Grande concerts, all of these kind of really cool, fun things downtown that I totally would not be able to afford if I didn't go here. So this is the engineering building. As you can see, there's a lot of classrooms here, places for students to study, maker spaces, design labs, a bunch of really cool civil engineering displays that are over there. So at Vanderbilt, the professors here are really invested in their students. They always want their students to succeed. And that's on a kind of personal level too. A story that I like to tell is, behind me you see this auditorium called the Jacobs Believed in Me Auditorium. And it does have a namesake. So basically, many, many years ago, there was a student who came to Vanderbilt and was gonna be an engineering student, but kind of got to his first semester and decided that college was not for him. He was struggling through his classes, had a really hard time fitting in academically. He felt, you know, stressed, he felt overwhelmed. So he emailed his professors and he decided that he was gonna drop out. So he basically emailed his professors and let them know that he was going to drop out of school. And his professors basically all emailed him back and said, "I'm really sorry about that, you know, best of luck in your future pursuits." But one specific professor emailed him back and said, "All right, that's fine, you can drop out, but first, come meet with me." And so the student went and came and met with the professor, and somewhere in the course of that 30-minute discussion, the professor convinced the student to stay at Vanderbilt and just, you know, try his best to get the engineering degree. Well, anyways, fast forward 4 years, this student graduates from Vanderbilt with an engineering degree and goes on to become super rich and donates money back to the school for this brand new auditorium in the professor's name. The professor's name was Jacob, so the auditorium is called the Jacobs Believed in Me Auditorium. And I think that really speaks to how much Vanderbilt professors care about their students. My poli-sci professor hosts a breakfast club every, you know, Tuesday before class. My Spanish professor, once I completely slept through an exam, and she was basically like, "It's okay, take it another time." They're understanding, they are here for you, and they just want you to succeed. So we just wanted to end the tour by talking a little bit about why we chose Vanderbilt. So for me, it really was the location. I love going to college in Nashville, in a big city. It really doesn't get any better than this. And Nashville's an amazing college town with really good access to different parks around. So you can do things like cliff jumping and go downtown.
For me, I'd have to say my why Vandy is the people. Everyone's just so willing to like talk to each other, and people have such niche interests and things that they're working on, and they're so ready to talk about it. You can tell how passionate they are about everything that they do. I'm like sometimes out in our common room lobby and people will be talking about things that they're really passionate about for like hours, just like, you know, spending time with each other and like sharing what is important to them, and I think that's just really meaningful, and it's hard to find sometimes, so I'm glad I found it here.
Yeah, like Swathi was saying, I think every Vanderbilt student is so much more than just a student. And especially like on the administrative level, they've done a really good job of increasing the socioeconomic, geographic, and racial diversity of campus. If you came to Vanderbilt maybe like 40, 50 years ago, I think you would see a completely different student body, a completely different vibe, a completely different campus. And I think that's so special to be able to be here with so many different people from so many different areas. And also through like programs like Experience Vanderbilt, where the university basically just funds whatever student org you want to do. It makes things like Wilderness Club or Greek Life accessible for people who don't usually have it. And that's why I love Vanderbilt. Final shameless plug, follow us on Instagram at Miles Borowski,
at Swathi.Gorilla,
at Michael.Berry,
and drop a like
comment down below if you want to see us do another video.
If you want part two, we'll bring back part two. We'll all fly to Vanderbilt.
We'll do it amid corona crisis.
Mid corona crisis to make you guys a video.
Just because we like making content.
So
it's all about the people.
Have any questions? Feel free to comment. And thanks for watching.